My college sorority is different. Only half the members are human. The initiation. It came to our attention that you're not like the other girls. Please consider joining the Psi Sisters this semester. Here's our contact info. XXXX. The envelope was golden and cotton candy pink, and the calligraphy was perfectly round and girly. I chuckled, and my friend Paula peeked above my shoulder. We were at the cafe to get some studying done, since the people in the neighboring rooms wouldn't shut up. Paula and I haven't really been close in high school, but now that we were in the same college, we decided to stick together. At least for me, it wasn't that I disliked her, we just didn't have a lot in common. "That's very like the other girls to me," Paula remarked. She was one of those sportsy, one-of-the-boys type. I just shoved the paper in my bag, but I think about it a lot. The coffee barista winked to me. She was a gorgeous, natural blonde, tall, and with freckles. It was impossible not to notice her, not only because of her looks, but because she seemed to know every patron and have a lively chat with each of them. She knew how to brighten someone's day. It took her less than a week to learn my name and my beverage of choice. "It's Sam, right?" she smiled brightly. We were alone at the cafe. "Samantha Myers?" I looked a little surprised, as I'm pretty sure I never said my last name there, if at all, but I nodded. "I'm the one who sent you the Psi Sisters invitation, of course." She expertly poured milk over my cappuccino, creating a pretty latte art heart. "Your talent is easy to miss, but mine makes sure I won't." She put the cup next to me and moved to welcome another client. The brief glance she shot me told me that the beautiful coffee barista, her name tag said simply, "Hey babe," knew everything there was to know about me. And we were oddly fine about it. You see, I'm not exactly special, but my grandmother taught me how to see people's auras. I don't go around seeing things on everyone like that Nickelback music video. I need to at least quickly touch someone. Usually shaking hands is enough to trigger my ability. Everyone's aura has a color and a word associated to it whispered inside my mind. Most people I meet have a light blue aura, friendly, or light green, safe, meaning the person is mostly neutral, or light red, angry. Light red doesn't mean the person is unapproachable. It usually means they have no patience with bullshit. My mother is a light red, and we get along well, but not as well as my father, light blue, and me. I can't see my own aura, by the way. Paula is a light green. People like that are harmless enough, but mostly uninteresting. More rare auras are purple, wise, just like my late grandmother, or yellow, imaginative, like my younger brother. So far, I only used my ability for minor tasks, such as finding out if a guy my friend likes is a good person, or the time I discovered who accidentally let the class hamster die in elementary school. It turns out that you can see speckles of black and crimson when someone feels guilty. I am yet to see a completely black or completely white aura, but I've seen lots of shades, nuances, gray included. Gray usually means a person is uninterested in life and others. After that day in the cafe, I didn't see "Hey babe." Instead, the barista was a really nice blue-haired guy who had no idea where she was, and he didn't know her name either. I admit, I accepted the invitation to the Psi Sisters mostly because of "Hey babe." I wanted to see what color her aura was, and if I'm being honest, I was crushing on her a little bit. On the appointed night, Paula had a basketball game. Being tall and athletic, she was already on the team. And I had no other friends in the campus yet, so I headed to the house of Psi alone. It's a beautiful place, a small mansion made of yellow bricks and pearly white embroidery. At the end of the cul-de-sac, it's easy to park. I don't have a car, but it's quite noticeable. And as soon as you cross the open white gates, you are welcomed by a beautiful garden and the smell of ratranis, or night-blooming jasmines. Although I soon came to learn that, in the house of Psi, their perfume is perpetual, even during the day. As I entered the double doors, the large entrance hall was dimly lit in a cozy fashion. At least a dozen girls were scattered around the room in small groups, chatting and drinking from red plastic cups. "Oh, hey!" the blonde barista approached me, surprising me with a hug. She then turned to the others. "Bring Bast, we're ready to start." She then closed the doors and turned on an ultraviolet light, making a pattern appear on the floor. It was clearly a witchcraft circle, full of intricate figures. Mandalas, moons, and pentagrams were the most recognizable. The light mood immediately turned somber, and all the girls sat around the circle. Hey Babe led me to sit on her right side. Just then, I noticed that at least 5 members were wearing hoods over their faces. After everyone sat, we waited in silence for a few seconds, before a pristine, white cat entered the circle, stopping right in the middle. It was the prettiest, silkiest cat I've ever seen, except that it had 3 eyes. It gave a long meow, then laid down to take a nap, the forehead eye still open and paying attention. I felt a bit unnerved, but incredibly protected by the cat's presence. Like, as long as I was close to it, I was safe from everything dark in the world. Sisters, today we welcome 2 young talents to our coven, Hey Babe announced. Please raise your hands in blessing to Sam, an aura reader, and Jenny, a magic botanist. As the other girls extended their hands towards me, I felt incredibly warm, like someone in the world truly cared about me, like a sister. A younger, weaker sister. Jenny, tell us more about yourself, Hey Babe asked. A few other girls leaned in slightly, happy to pay attention to their new sister. Jenny was very pale and short, with curly terracotta hair. She was cute, like a 12-year-old. So, hey everyone! Her voice was giddy and shy, making her seem even younger. I'm happy to be here. My power is talking to plants. I know it's not as amazing as everyone else's, but I love it. They are my best friends in a sense. I hope you all will be my best friends too. Everyone clapped excitedly. And what the night blooming jasmines told you about me? Hey Babe asked happily. They said I'd be happy as long as I didn't cross you. Good, Hey Babe exclaimed. But everyone else was suddenly quiet. I swear I felt a collective shiver all over the room. Now you, Sam, go ahead. My face was suddenly red and sweaty. I didn't feel worthy of being in front of such incredible people. I still didn't know how incredible they were, but I could feel some women in the room were like forces of nature, beautiful and terrible. I'm Samantha. I plan on majoring in German literature, and my ability is seeing auras. Some people shifted uncomfortably. But don't worry, I can only do it if I hold your hand or touch your arm for a while. I see colors in a halo over your head, and in my mind, I hear a word related to your character. Twins, come here, Hey Babe asked. A woman in a beautiful cloak moved closer to me. Unlike most, she was a full-fledged adult, probably in her mid-20s, and both her eyes and hair were so enticingly black that you couldn't look away. I was forever mesmerized, looking for a tint of brown in the most even blackness I ever saw. Let her read your aura. She extended me a delicate hand with long fingers. I held it. Her aura was so overwhelmingly dark purple that I had to close my eyes, bedazzled like I had stared into the sun itself. Ancient. In my mind, I was informed that she was so much older than she looked. She gave me a half smile. So I'm twins. Some of our names are too dangerous to say, so I'd rather you call me that. Did you manage to read my aura? Yes, you're ancient, I replied, and the room burst into laughter. Your name should be Ruins, not Twins, a girl wearing long gloves said, mispronouncing the word to make a pun. Shut up, multiplier. Go take a walk in the desert like your great-great-great-grandfather or something, Twins replied, but she was laughing too. Now, one more thing before Bastet blesses the two of you, Hey Babe said. And I instinctively looked to the cat. It was stretching, the third eye still open while the other two rested. Read mine. She held my hand with her too, and my vision started going black. Before passing out, I saw a flash of color I've never seen before, and I'm unable to describe. It's like my eyes suddenly gained a superhuman ability, like watching a melody or licking a word. I heard some worried voices and a few giggles as my body went limp, and I realized I was falling. Fortunately, I fell in someone's comfortable lap. Are you crazy? No normal human can handle this. Who said she's a normal human? You could have killed her, Of course I made sure she would be fine. The voices started to dissolve in the blackness of my mind, and then I saw Hey Babe's face, smiling and winking at me. I felt something larger than fear, so much larger that I wasn't scared per se. I was overwhelmed by her unfathomable nature, but equally charmed. "Open your eyes, Sam," she gently commanded, and suddenly I was fine again. Bastet was meowing lightly, blinking its three yellow eyes at me. "You're okay?"
"Yeah, sorry," I said.
"Don't be. You have an incredible inner force," Twins remarked, her face still frowned in worry. "So, what's the word and color of my aura?" Hey Babe asked playfully. I can't describe the color I saw. It fleets my mind every time I try, I replied. But the word, literally in capital letters, is doom.